Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I pray that God, my Father, as we come before your presence, God, hear us, Lord, when we call upon you, because your word says you would answer us even before we open our mouth to pray, God. Lord, my Father, in the name of Jesus, I bring every one of us into your hand, God. I pray divine protection, God. I bleed the blood of Jesus over their lives, God, my Father. In the mighty name of Jesus, I destroy and cast out every satanic dream that torment your people while they were sleeping. Endless evil dreams, every satanic dreams, I crush them, I bind them, and I render them powerless in the name of Jesus. Satanic dreams that leave the person wondered and scared and terrified. You, that witchcraft dreams, you came to the person while they were sleeping. You are a liar. I destroy you. I command you by the power and the blood of Jesus. You will not blunt any sickness, or you not cause anything with your dreams. Your dreams has been wasted in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Anyone who is sick this morning, I bring them to you, God, my Father. I destroy sickness and the diseases. I command every pain in your body to destroy it in Jesus' name, to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. You, that pain in that person, get out in the name of Jesus, my God, my Father, in the name of Jesus. I lift up your name to honor you, to thank you, God. Loving Father, I acknowledge your name. I thank you and I give all the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen. I want to welcome you this morning. I welcome everyone who has joined the prayer conference. Welcome. Hello, hello, everyone. Thank you. Thank you for coming. This is your host, Dr. Reverend Christine Isigi. Welcome you. Once again, I want to ask you, please don't make a lot of noise. When you are praying, just pray slowly, because your voice, it affects some people's ears. So, and also you can unmute your phone. If you unmute your phone, we won't have your problem. And you put your phone away from your mouth. Don't put your phone so close to your mouth, because your echo, it enters to people's ears. Some people, they get distracted when they hear that. We thank God that God is good. You remember, we are praying one accord. We don't want to pray very high or slowly. We just be one accord and be attentive. Be attentive when we are praying. When I say in Jesus' name, just say amen. The video will be up and you can follow it later. So I know that you are moved with the Holy Spirit. But this is the what we are using prayer, right? Whereby it is very sensitive and the ears of people. And now that is how you have to be also be conscious with other people. Thank you, fell mighty God bless you. This is Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry. We are praying, prayer and fasting to seek those who are looking for the fruit of the womb. And also we are praying out for our breakthrough in the name of Jesus. Let's pray once again. And I ask you to pray, just pray. Don't shout so around. Let's pray. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you, God. We love you, God. We honor you. We acknowledge your name. We give you all the glory, Jesus. Oh, Lord, my Father, we want to thank you so much, God. We honor you. We acknowledge you, God. Once again, we thank you, Father. Loving Father, we honor you. We welcome you, Lord. We thank you for everything, God. We thank you for these prayers, Lord. We thank you for the prayer conference, my God. We thank you this morning, God, my Father. God, we honor you, Jesus. I pray that, God, you will lead us in this prayer, God, this prayer season, God. My God, my Father, in the name of Jesus, I acknowledge your name and thank you. Thank you, Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. I'm going to talk the subject called Releasing Deliverance Faith in Your Spirit. Releasing Deliverance Faith in Your Spirit. Releasing Deliverance Faith in Your Spirit. You need deliverance faith in your spirit. And I'm going to look from the book of Luke 10, verse 19, and Matthew 16, verse 19. Luke 10, verse 19, the Bible says, you have been given power to trumpet serpents and scorpions. You have been given power. You have been given power. Jesus Christ has given you power. And in the book of Matthew 16 verse 19, the Bible says, I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatsoever you bind on earth shall have been bound in heaven, and whatsoever you loose on earth shall have been loosed in heaven. So you have been given key. You've been given keys, not even one key. You have been given a bunch of keys to go and open anything you want from heaven. And the Bible is telling you, anything you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. And whatever you lose on earth shall have been loosed in heaven. So as you meditate upon that scripture, as you are releasing your spirit, as you are releasing deliverance, faith in your spirit, you will meditate and speak loud in you that I have the keys of the kingdom of heaven. So once you have the keys, you can enter without any problem. But when you don't have the key, you cannot enter. But God, who has given you keys of the kingdom of heaven, you can go and choose anything you want when you know how to release deliverance faith in your spirit. Your faith can change your world. But no matter how great your faith is, you must first release your faith if it is going to change the circumstances that are affecting your affecting you negatively. So people of God, you may say, I don't have faith. I don't have any faith in me. Jesus give us as little as mustard seed. This is what Jesus said. I know the disciples of Jesus, they were like you and me. They were wondering what Jesus was talking about. But Jesus said, deliverance has come to you. That deliverance, big deliverance, that you should take a step of faith and believe the word, because you have been given authority to trumpet on serpents and scorpions. And not only that, and also you have been given the keys. You remember your feet, you trumpet on your step, the demon is on your feet, you step on them, and they cannot do you anything. So that is a big deliverance. That these demons, the snakes and the demons, serpent is demons, is Satan himself. As scorpions are demons. Now you have been given power against those strong demons. As you know that, then you have faith that these animals, they cannot harm you by all means. Then you have been given the keys to go to heaven by yourself. God has not only given you dominion over your life, the power and the authority to govern and control, but he has also commissioned you to subdue, to bring law and ordering, and utterly defeat these things that are not in agree with his will for you. Genesis 1:26-28. You have been given dominion. You have been given dominion to rule over in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You have been given dominion. You know, when you have been given dominion, dominion is everything. So, as the Bible says, praise be the name of Jesus. Let's look at the book of Genesis 1:26-28. The Bible says, and God said, let us make a man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him. Male and female created in them. And God said, And God blessed them, and God said unto them, be fruitful and multiply, and replenish the earth and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. You know, God has not given animals dominion. God has not given anything about human being, the human being that he made. He made human being in his own image. So he has given them dominion over all living things in the earth. So that is a big deliverance that you have. So when you have been given a dominion to take over all these things, any living things, you have power to destroy any power of the enemy that is working against you. To destroy every powers of demons, any powers of the devil, any witchcraft that is not from God. Anything that is not from God, you've been given authority and dominion. You will destroy them in the name of Jesus Christ. Let's look in the book of Hebrews 11 verse 3. The book of Hebrews 11 verse 3. The Bible said, through faith we understand that the worlds were formed by the word of God, so that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. Carefully and notice how God created everything that is existing. How did he do it? He spoke it. God spoke the word, and he believed that his words has the power to change things from what they were, nothing, to what he wanted. Light the heavens and the earth, the ocean and life and mankind. So you speak the word. When you speak the word, you believe it. You believe that the word you are speaking is life. Remember Job 22 verse 28, it said, speak the word will be established. So now when you speak the word in your spirit, you command the demons, you claim the word. Because you know, you've been given keys. What are you going to do with the keys that you have given in heaven? And in heaven, there's a lot of stuff that you need from there. You need good husband, you need good wife, you need children, you need everything from the heaven. So you go with the key to open your home. You go there, you say, God, I have the key that you have given me. Therefore, God, I am coming to you right now. I need children. I need a husband. I am opening that door of husband to come to me now. You enter. You believe the word of God because you have been given it. You have been given it, the word of God. Therefore, the word of God is life and it cannot change. In another words, believe that our words can and will bring forth the change we want in our life and bring circumstance and to align with the word, the will of God for our life. Yes, we thank God in the name of Jesus Christ. Jesus promised and God says yes. Jesus promised and God says yes. And what is more, we are assured that all the promises of God in him are yeah, in him, amen, and to the glory of God. Hallelujah. By us. In Jesus' name. So in 2 Corinthians 1:20, that's what the Bible says. All the promise of God is amen. No promise of God says no. The promise of God is this for you and your children. Therefore, people of God, we have to believe the word of God. We have to have this word of God in our spirit. In another word, Jesus said clearly in Matthew 11 verse 22 that faith in God is believing what he has said about us and our words. And then he went on to reassure us that his promise as written as with every other promises is yes and amen. So be it in him. You have authority. You shall decree a thing and it shall be established. You have authority. In Luke 10 verse 19, behold, I give unto you power, authority over serpents and scorpions, demonic powers, and over all the powers of the enemies, even Satan, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. This is Jesus assuring you. He has promised you. He has given you power and authority. Big deliverance you have, but you have no idea what you have. The Bible says in Job 22, verse 28 to 29, the Bible says, you shall also a degree a thing, and it shall be established unto you. So light will shine on your ways. When they cast you down and you say extortion shall come, then he shall save the humble person. The Lord will save humble person. Truly I said unto you, hallelujah. That is Matthew 18, verse 18. Truly, truly, I said unto you, whatsoever you shall bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatsoever you shall loose on earth shall be loosened in heaven. God has promised us good things. God has said that when you release this deliverance faith in your spirit, you can stop any demon, any power that is tormenting you. You can stop that witch that is speaking negative against you. You can stop those gossip. You can stop that child of the devil that is working against you. You can stop that dreams that terrifying you. You cannot wake up when you fear, you check, you don't know. You can speak the word that it go like a sword to the ear, to the heart, to the enemies, and it will destroy them. You must be angry in your spirit. In Hebrews 10, verse 23, the Bible says, let us hold fast the profession, confession of our faith without waving the words that we speak, for he is faithful and promised. The Bible says in Hebrews 10, verse 23, it says, let us hold fast the confession of our faith without waving the words that we speak, for he is faithful that promised. Our God is so faithful that he has promised. It is true. God has promised. God has promised. His promise is a yeah, amen. It does not say no. God has promised us good things. My God, I thank you. In the book of Hebrews 10, verse 35, the Bible says, cast not away, therefore, your confidence. Cast not away, therefore, your confidence, faith and trust in him and his promises, which he has greatly compensation, promise of reward result. The promise of the reward that God has given. You release this promise in your spirit. Big deliverance. You will be delivered in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, we thank you, Father. My God and my Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. I want to honor you this morning, God. I pray that God, my Father, as I release faith to your people, God, I pray that God, my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, anything that is working against your people, any power that is attacking your people, I destroy them in the name of Jesus. I command you, powers of darkness, you will not prosper in the life of these people, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, my God. And my Father, in the name of Jesus, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. Therefore, because the Word itself is the Word of God, is the God himself is the Word. Therefore, I come with that Word, the same Word. God himself is the Word. Therefore, as this him is the Word, I am using the Word right now. By the power that created heaven and earth, you created heaven and earth, the same power that he created heaven and earth. I am now releasing them to the camp of the enemies that are tormenting your people, that are disgracing your people, that are fighting your people, to go there and bring big confusion in their camp. Let them start fighting themselves. They will destroy themselves. Every witchcraft that has planted any evil things in your life, the word of God will go to their camp and destroy them. Let them start destroying themselves in Jesus' name. I call upon fire of God to consume every problem that you are facing today. Anything that is working against you. In the mighty name of Jesus, every power of darkness, I destroy them in the name of Jesus. You that dark cloud over this person, I command you to clear the way in the mighty name of Jesus. Dark cloud, clear the way from these people in Jesus' name. I command the powers that is covering the dark cloud over your head, I command them to clear away in Jesus' name. Father, in the name of Jesus, I want to thank you. I want to thank you, and I thank you so much. For you alone, you are God. There is no one like you. We come to you, our Father. We know we depend on you. We believe in you, Lord. We pray that God, when we call you God, you will answer us, God, my Father. Your people have cried. Your people have been suffering a lot. They've been wondering what to do, but God, my Father, answered them. They have been wandering from church to church. They have been going from prophet to prophet, pastor to pastor. But today, wherever hear my voice, God, my Father, meet their needs, God. Answer them, oh God, my Father. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, anything that is not working against you, anything that is working against you, let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Any power of darkness that is following you, that does not want to go, let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Blood of Jesus, visit this person. Blood of Jesus, wash this person to be clean as snow, God. You have said, even if their sins is like blood, you will forgive them and wash them. This is your word. And we have taken it by faith and believe that God, you are able to forgive your people and clean them as white as snow. My God and my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, we magnify your name, Jesus. We worship you, O God, my Father and my God, in the name of Jesus Christ. When the witchcraft that are sitting on the mat, all sitting on their coven, speaking evil, chanting against them, let their words stand back to the heart. Let their words stand back to the head in the mighty name of Jesus. Anyone, any evil priest, any satanic prophet sitting on the mat, chanting against you, speaking against your children, speaking against your work, let them be destroyed in Jesus' name. All their words, they have been wasted in Jesus' name. Any power of darkness attacking your job, attacking the work of your hand, let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. My God, my Father, I pray that God, those who are looking for the fruit of the womb, God Almighty, my Father and my God, in the name of Jesus Christ, Father, open their womb, God. Open their womb because you have been given us keys to enter in heaven. I enter in heaven on their behalf, and I pray and open that room which is carrying children. And Lord, I release the children by faith in the mighty name of Jesus. They will receive their children in the name of Jesus. They will be conceived like Sarah conceived you at the age, at the holy age. And they will, those who are even menopause over age, God will do a miracle and they will conceive children in the name of Jesus Christ. My God, my Father, the sickness that you have that does not let you go, my God, I pray that God, let that sickness die. Let them be melted by fire. Let that sickness be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I pray for the prisoners. Those people who are in prison, they are human beings. They messed up by the power of darkness. Enemies has made them like that. Father, in the name of Jesus, some of them, they have repented, they have sorry, and they have been punished enough. It is their time that God, you have mercy. The grace, God, my Father, have mercy upon them. Let their beard come up and let them be released from that prison. Lord, the other people are waiting for jail or they are waiting for trial. My God, have mercy upon your people. Have mercy, God, Jesus. Have mercy and deliver them. Let them be released and be delivered in the name of Jesus. I pray that anything that you are looking, the Lord will meet it according to his riches and glory, my Father. God, I bleed the blood of Jesus. I want to thank you, Jesus. I give you all the glory, my Father. My Father and my God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Lord, we honor you. Jesus, we glorify your name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. 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 Thank you. Thank you very much. God bless you so much. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isiki, saying bye-bye to you. Today, tonight, we are going to have very powerful prayer. And you can invite your friends. Give them this number. 712-77-57085. Access code number 595119. Give them this number. They to invite them and let them join. Tonight we are going to have a deliverance prayer. And tomorrow morning we'll have the prayer for the fruits of the humble. We will be praying for those people because that's why we did the prayer and fasting. Now, because I know that God answered our prayers, and I know there's a lot of testimony. I was asking you on 2 days ago. My grandson was so sick. He was attacked from the school, and it was really bad. But after the prayer, my grandson was healed. He's at home now. He was discharged from the hospital. So we thank God that God is able to heal and to deliver. So your case also, it is, you are God going to answer you by fire. If you are patient, you are sick, God is going to heal you in Jesus' name. And remember to go to our website, www.overcomersdhministries.blogspot.ca. And we have number you can call me to, if you need prayers, you can reach me on our cell phone, 647-608-5207. Our cell phone number once again is 647-608-5207. Also, we have a landline. You can reach us. Sometimes if your cell phone is expensive or wherever, you can also reach us 905-487-9196. We have a free line. People without long distance, you can reach us. If you are in Northern America, Canada and the USA, you can, this is a free number, toll free. It is 877-241-3420. God bless you. God bless you so much. God bless you. God bless you. I love you so much. There's nothing I can do about it. See you tonight, 12 midnight. It is going to be very powerful. It is going to be fun. Welcome. Amen. Today we have our prayer meeting at Overcomers. We are going to have a big deliverance to 7 o'clock today. If you are living around here, Canada, Ontario, around Toronto, you can always, you are welcome. You are welcome to come and visit us. Plan to come, even if you are from other country, if you want to come and visit us on Fridays, let us know to welcome you and join us in our deliverance. People who have been coming there, they have testimony. They have seen big, big, big miracles happening there. Well, you are welcome to join us. Thank you very much. God bless you. Have a wonderful day.
Thank you, Dr. Thank you.
Thank
you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much.
I'll call you later on tonight.
Yes, call me. Thank you. God bless you. Have a wonderful, wonderful time. Thank you. God bless you. Thank you. Bye bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. I love you. Thank you. Bye.